Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to paint on an 11 by 14 Creative Series stretch canvas by Fredericks, and I'm going to try something completely different. I've never attempted to paint like this before, so I really wasn't sure how it was going to turn out. And I wasn't like super happy with how it turned out, but it was different and I do like to experiment. So the one thing I don't like about it was the color that I chose to use as my background. I use like a yellowish kind of orange. I wish that I had went with maybe a bluish green or something like that, but it is what it is. It's a different technique, and I just kind of wanted to share it with you guys. So right now I'm using black craft paint and a flat brush from the Deco Clarity set, and I'm just going to block in all of my trees first. Now I'm just going to grab a little bit of brown craft paint to paint some of the background trees. And this brush is from Hobby Lobby. It's a goat hair mop brush. This is a bristle fan brush by Golden Maple. I believe it's a number 2. Now I'm going to use some Golden Fluid acrylics. This one is Indian Yellow, and I'm going to mix it with Alizarin Crimson. This one is white craft paint. I'm going to use a slightly bigger mop brush than what I used last time. This one is clean. And I'm going to start by putting on white paint, white craft paint, where I want the brightest part of my background. Then I'm going to dip that same brush into that mixture that I'm just mixed up, the Indian yellow and alizarin crimson. And I'm going to kind of blend all of that together. And I'm going to leave it really light in the middle and then just keep working my way out and blend, obviously, until it gets a little bit darker. So it'll be lighter in the middle and then darker as it goes out. Now, if you'll notice, I leave like a little gap right here. I paint the orange color and I leave a gap between the orange color and the lighter color. And then I blend into the lighter color. That way I'm not putting too much of the darker color right on top of the lighter color, and it's just easier to blend that way. Here's another example. I'm starting in the darker area and then blending into the lighter area. Like I work my way into the light color. And here I wanted to make this just a little bit brighter, so I'm starting right in the middle and then working my way out into the darker color. If I start with too much light right on the edge, like where the lighter color meets the darker color, then it's not going to blend as well. So the black was apparently a bad choice, like when I blocked in the trees at the very beginning of the video. So I'm just going to go back with some of that same orange mixture, the Indian yellow and alizarin crimson, and go back over top of those trees just to make them, you know, the right color for background trees. Now, since the light source is behind these trees, I'm going to make the edges of the trees a little bit lighter. So I'm going to give them some highlight, and I'm just going to use the same color that I've been using, the Indian yellow and the alizarin crimson. And I'm back to using my flat brush from the Deco Clarity set. Now I'm going to use some black craft paint and my number 2 bristle fan brush by Golden Maple. And I'm just going to hold my brush 90 degrees to the canvas. And I'm just going to tap in like a few little leaves. I'm going to flip and rotate my brush so that I'm not getting the same repeating pattern over and over. So I usually enhance or whatever my acrylic paintings with oil paint. And this time it was completely unnecessary. It didn't do anything, but what I want to do is match the same color in oil that I was using for acrylic. But the Indian yellow oil paint that I have is not the same color as the golden fluid acrylics. Even though they both say Indian yellow, they're not the same color. So I have to use some, like two different Indian yellows plus some alizarin crimson oil to try to get that same shade. So that's what I'm doing right now. But to be completely honest with you, I go back over some of this with oil paint and it did not make any difference whatsoever. It didn't look any better. It didn't look any worse. It just wasn't any different. So I guess this part was kind of a waste of time, but I figured I would leave this part of the video in for you in case you wanted to try it. Okay, so now I'm going along the edges again, just to really kind of brighten them up. I totally could have done this with acrylic paint, but here we are. And now I'm going to paint a couple of fireflies. And I'm going to use Viridian Green and White. And I'm going to use a small fine detail brush from the Deco Fine Detail Set. I'm going to start by just kind of smearing on some paint. Make sure it's like blurry around the edges. And then I'll just keep gradually adding more white until it kind of looks like it's glowing. And then just one little tiny white dot in the center. Just pure white, so that it looks like it's glowing. I don't want them all to be the same shape or size, so I'm making some smaller ones now. I'm not going to smear these or try to make them any brighter. This is just the Viridian green and white paint mixed together, just so that it looks like there's different shapes, different sizes. Some of them are brighter than others. I did take a little bit of a break from posting tutorials for you guys. I didn't really think anybody would notice, but a couple of you did, and I really appreciate the people that did notice. But hopefully I can get back into the swing of sharing tutorials with you guys. If there's anything else that you would like to see in the future, drop me a comment and let me know, and I'll see what I can do. And that's about all I've got for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked today's video, give that like button a tap and please consider subscribing. You can also find me on Instagram and TikTok, where I upload content almost daily. Thank you for watching.